So I wanted to talk to you about, like, because we're both women bosses and you own this ranch.
Yes,
and,
I do.
You know, what happens to us women that are bosses and the type of bullying that happens is so outrageous.
Well, it is because, and it comes from, as you said, women and men. But I think especially women,
yes.
they're jealous. And if you happen to be beautiful and smart along with being a boss, they're even more jealous. And so I guess to make themselves feel better, they decide they need to bully or tell stories and whatever, and then you've got to deal with that, along with all the stuff you deal with on a day-to-day basis anyway.
Exactly, running your own business and, you know, handling the money and the employees, and then you get bullying, and it really makes it really difficult. And it's like, I always call it crab mentality. They want to be crabs in the barrel, and they see you, you're this beautiful, strong woman that, I mean, goodness, you're doing things that normally men do. I mean, you're running a ranch, and you're doing it by yourself as a single woman. I mean, it comes with so many issues because you got women like, we got to take her out. How do we take her out? And then you got guys that are hating on you because they're like, oh, she didn't date me, or oh, God, you know, and they got the women that they get with that's like jealous because he's in love with you, or, you know, it's like such a mess. But I have to say, I'm so honestly proud of you, like really just hanging in there and being a strong woman. And, you know, obviously the show is She's the Boss, and, you know, we want to inspire and empower women and have women understand that the bullying, like, join the ride, like, girls, we can empower you too.
Yep.
You don't have to hate on others and drink the hate and Kool-Aid.
Nope. Just go out and do, you know, make your own kingdom.
You can.
A queendom, if you will. There's nothing that we can't do if
that we cannot
really
do.
Seriously want to do it.
And if you spend more energy on empowering yourself instead of energy on hurting others,
negativity,
you would be very successful. So, you know, focus on success and how to overcome no matter where you are. I mean, let's face it, we've all been through goodness, everything from nothing.
Yeah, I've been up, down, and all around. Last year, I thought was one of the most horrible times of my life with 70-something feet of water in here. I lost every single vehicle I owned, from a 650 to a 350 to an SUV, to the farm truck, the tractor. All my trailers were underwater. And I thought, how much worse could it really get? And we were unfortunate that we lost three or four horses on the ranch during that flash flood. And then this year, here comes Harvey. And at least had enough warning that all the, we got feed and hay set up in an evacuation pasture on Wednesday. We moved horses Thursday and Friday. We moved saddles, 100 saddles and blankets and all the stuff that goes with a horse business on Friday, Saturday till the rain started. And I was going to stay here in the house. I had one of my employees and another young man and the employee's son. And then we were going to ride it out. And about mid-morning on Sunday, the 27th, my great barn manager called and she goes, I'm sending a boat in. I'm like, no, we're fine. She goes, Darylyn, it may go over the house. And I'm like, really? And I might have stayed, except I had three other lives to think about and seven dogs and one cat. And so the boat came out and it was probably 8 feet deep off the ground at that point. And everybody, always make a list of what you take in an emergency, because I did not have a list and I'm running for the safe. I got car titles, horse passports, a few clothes that were just hysterical when I got to wherever I was going. And that was it. And got in the boat with this stuff and off we went. Boat had to make two trips for all of us and the dogs, and went to a girlfriend's house to set it out. And it did not go over the roof of the house, but the bottom of my elevated house is 15 feet, and it did get almost 3 feet in the house. Oh, I put a computer up in the loft. That was the only, my main computer, thank God, went up in the loft in a big Ziploc. So that was all I had time to really move up. And again, I'm being very optimistic. It's really not going to get in the house. So all my tax records, pictures, three generations of pictures, everything done, gone, and over 100 pair of boots. And because I used to work for Tony Lama. That's what bought and built this place, was I was a Tony Lama rep. See, I was a boss of myself on the road. back in the 70s. And I was one of the few women that was out, a sales rep, out on the road. I covered South Texas and Southern Louisiana. And that was the first time I learned I could really, you know, do a man's job and do it well. And so I had good years there. And then I had a video production company, and we made training equestrian tapes from everything from rodeo to general riding to English as well. And then I did a TV show, and I did a video magazine, a quarterly video magazine. And I loved it all, and I loved the history and working with some of the top horse people in the world. I mean, I always joke that it's like having a baby with somebody, you know, the creation of it and putting it together. And the hours and hours that you spend in a studio getting the final cuts done. And then I was 48, 1998, and I'm like, we went through another flood. In 94, it flooded my whole studio, went over the roof of a building that's not even here anymore. And we moved
here
a couple
of years. Here in Houston?
Right here on this ranch. Yeah, I had my original 1,800 square foot home that I bought when I was 24, was on this property, and we had made it into the video studio. And it flooded over the roof of it. And so we ended up buying another house in the neighborhood, and we made that a studio, and then we ended up moving it downtown Houston. Well, I didn't like the drive to downtown Houston. I'd had my work at my home too long, and I was still raising two daughters, and so I sold the video company, said, I'm going to simplify my life. Are you going to giggle there? Yeah. And everybody else did. And I'm like, no, I really am. I'm going to just do horses. I'm going to compete and do a little training, and that's it. And it worked for maybe 6 months or a year, and then the person came by with his daughter and said, will you take us on a trail ride? And I'm like, yeah, okay. And that started it. And I just was doing it originally to supplement my other horse business, but now the tail is wagging the dog again. We have 65 horses, 100 saddles. We put, on a good day, it's not unusual, but 100 people plus on horses and out into this fabulous park.
This is really, really amazing. So you just, you're like a numbers person. You're just like, okay, this kind of can work.